Well, I think, at least my view is, anytime, and that's why Mecklenburg works pretty well. We've got a majority of district at, for the large part, and as Representative Carney says, we have a few at large to make sure there's kind of that holistic view. But Representative, what any redistricting should do, if it's doing well, at least this is just my view of the world, every group of residents, because counties are, they're very different what the needs are in Pineville, say, versus what may happen in Huntersville, what may be in Center City, Charlotte. And everybody, and it's the classic, needs to be represented at the table. So by having districts and an overlay of a few at large, it seems to me that's a good thing. So everybody has a voice at the table, rather than in places where it's been, where maybe even a neighborhood has three or four county commissioners that live that close to them and nobody else is represented, somewhat locally close to them. And that's all that's primarily trying to do. But I don't discard that we need to be diligent in making sure it's balanced and not skewing things purely for political reasons. And a lot of that plays. I mean, there's no question. There's politics in this. I mean, it just is.
You know, I've got to speak up one more time. having been a former county commissioner and serving this county at large for 3 terms, first of all, I don't think I would have ever voted as a board, or I would have ever gone to Raleigh and said, change what my local voters had voted for in my county. What happened in Wake County is, in this last election, 2014, the county commissioners, let me back up, the voters in the county had been watching and observing what had happened with their school board race. And it was a very divisive racial issue within Wake County, and the whole state was watching. So the county commission decided, the residents decided, we need, our only hope for our public schools is to change the districts for the county commission. So what they did was they got people to run. They got good people to run. And the Democrats swept the county commission in November 2014. And immediately, not a request from the county commission board, but immediately, some senators, or a senator, I don't remember who filed the bill, put that bill in to totally change the makeup of how and the redistricting. So there, it is political. And you know, and for this Wake County issue that we're dealing with, it was political. It is political. And to me, any time that Raleigh steps in to local government's control of their governing bodies and the way they elect them, it's political.
The answer to that question.
I would have to be able to.
Okay. Draft the bill. That's a good idea. Draft the bill. Give the details of the bill, who, what, when, and submit it to me and to this Mecklenburg delegation. I think that's a great idea.
And then work on it.
Good. And then work on it. And the second thing, and to the State Board of Education, because they are the ones that really put together the curriculum and decide what is to be taught. So that's where you start. But I welcome that bill, and I welcome you to draft it and submit it to us as a delegation and to me.
What's important to know is the HBCUs, particularly in the UNC system, and as I've talked to the chancellors, have issues with some of the funding. And there's been discussion of even trying to close them, Elizabeth City State most specifically. So one of the things is to recognize they have a historical significance, like we're talking about. There is a need in that community and a need to make sure we keep those schools strong as well. And they're a key part of that whole UNC system. That was my only point.
And to go along with that, Bill 7706, that will address some needs for historically black universities and colleges. And what we're looking at, and we've met the Board of Governors, we've met with those who are responsible for looking at enrollments, curriculum, and looking at graduation rates. That bill will address much of those, because what it's looking at is maybe a different paradigm. We're putting forth where you can get a license plate, and a part of that money will be set aside, kind of fund, endowment fund, to assist these universities. So so that they can be strong, because they've given us some of the best professionals that we have in this country.
One just side comment that's important on the HBCUs. Okay, go ahead then.
Let me just say that the HBCU, the governor's board did come and speak to the legislative black caucus members. And they spent about 2 hours with us several weeks ago. And it was a conversation about closing the Elizabeth City. They committed to us that it would not be closing, that they were going to try to do some restructuring down there and work on several issues with their economic problems on that campus. They also committed to us that they would not be looking at Winston-Salem State University as doing anything to that. I'm a graduate there as well. And I don't know if you all have seen it lately, but they were the number one state HBCU in the state producing jobs in the state of North Carolina. So we did get those commitments from them. But that is from the old board. We recently elected a new board. So that, just to let you know, that I is still on Elizabeth City. Winston-Salem State looks like they're going to be safe. Thank you.
Okay, Lloyd?
I was just going to say, one of the things, there needs to be equity and fairness in this. And as an example, UNC Charlotte just has a brand new student union. Western Carolina has a brand new nursing school. There's one in NC State's looking for brand new science. And the HBCUs candidly tend to get pushed to the back of the line. And here's an example, talking with Chancellor Saunders' wife. They want to, and there's a desperate need to put a brand new student union. It's actually embarrassing, that facility. And we need to get behind it as a state and support getting that building built. That's part of the comment.
One quick comment, and I respect my colleagues highly. But Senator Graham, what I've learned to do while I'm in Raleigh is to follow the money. The Board of Governors can say whatever they want to, but if they don't have the appropriations coming from the General Assembly, those schools are in trouble. Follow the money.
A referendum can be attached to any of these pieces of dealing with local government. It's just the will of the legislature. And North Carolina is a state that is controlled by the legislature. Local governments have to come to Raleigh, this is in the Constitution and all that, have to come to Raleigh for everything, to get permission to sneeze. And how often they can sneeze. So that would take a major. I just don't know if that could possibly be, because it would take a constitutional change. But we could possibly, if the will was there, to add a referendum, which would require the people to have to vote. But then when you look at our voting record, how bad it is, if you put a referendum on it, that still doesn't say that we that whatever you want or don't want is going to happen. So bottom line is, Raleigh should just, we agree, and we didn't do it when we were in leadership, but the first thing that the other party did, and I was on local government, and the first thing they did was starting micromanaging local government, repealing annexations and all, But one good thing about our governor, the governor, he has spoken out against some of this micromanaging. So I'm hoping that if any of this goes, gets as far as his desk, that he will veto it.
Beverly is exactly right that Raleigh can control what happens, and with the fiscal impact that's going on at local governments, I've now deemed it death by a thousand cuts. We keep cutting the local governments, and what's going to happen is some of these rural municipalities and the bigger cities that lift them up, it can be quite devastating. But how you change it is at the ballot box. The only way you can change that is with like minds that are steadfast, and it's so interesting to me. When I ran, first ran for county commission, everything that I heard, I'm a Democrat, but I heard from my counter candidates from the other party was local control. They supported local control from the federal government, from the state, and now the tides, and I did too, we were all together, and now the tides have turned when you're in charge. It's changed, and I can't, when I go back historically, I can't put my finger on it. But Beverly, what it would have said, and I'm going to help her here, is we did have an amendment on the floor in the House to the Wake County bill to have a referendum, and it was shot down.